About the first major college football team back in the skies after the September 11 attacks. The Rice Owls, who took a 48-3 shellacking at Nebraska on Thursday night, a game pushed back from Saturday. So the Owls experienced first what so many teams will have to experience, getting back to normalcy in abnormal times for traveling. Curry Kirkpatrick joined them for their journey to the heartland.
The Rice Owls, representing one of America's most honored academic institutions, the smallest school in the NCAA, playing the game on the Division 1A level. But on Wednesday at high noon, these young men became distinguished for something vastly different. They were the first team in the land to board an airplane and fly off into suddenly scary skies to play a football game.
I'm not really worried about it. I just said a little prayer before I left this morning, and my mother called me just to wish the team luck and tell me to be careful and everything.
I don't feel like me getting on the planes, helping the country. I feel like firefighters and police officers and volunteers in New York and Washington going, you know, helping out in any way they can. I think that's the people that, you know, should feel honor.
There's certain things that cause you concern, but certain things you got no control of. We're not going to hide and shrink back from doing the things that we're going to do in life. And the main thing is we're going to enjoy living today the best we can, because tomorrow's not guaranteed.
Not that the Owls' journey was without incident. Right away, one of the team buses broke down in Houston.
I've been on these buses for 9 years at Rice. That's the first time we've had a bus breakdown on the way to the airport. I guess as long as you don't believe in omens, you're all right.
As the Owls climbed onto their plane, a team official expressed satisfaction with the safety precautions on the ground.
There was a lot more security than there usually is. They walked through the bus, they checked some of the bags underneath. They came in, looked like they did a spot check up inside. They checked the motor of the buses before we drove in, and it was really quite reassuring.
Securely on board, the Owls engaged in business, rather fun, as usual. Teammates rag star linebacker Dan Dawson about his childhood Sesame Street pillow.
Same old, same old. No one's worried about it. We're all ready to get back into normalcy, and we're looking forward to it.
At the team hotel, the Owls joined in prayer.
Where was God on Tuesday? God, in many ways, was the same place on Tuesday, God the Father, where he was when he watched his own son crucified. And Father, I pray, Lord, spiritually, that everybody in this room would sense your presence with them.
As all of us have sadly discovered, the horrific events of Tuesday 9-1-1-0-1 have touched everyone everywhere, no less here in Nebraska and on the Rice football team. Sophomore Krista Nunbrun is an offensive tackle from Houston who has two uncles in the New York area, one a policeman, one a fireman. Both went missing for an entire day before his family finally, thankfully, made contact.
My mother and I were sitting there watching the news, and we were just in awe, and our hearts just went out to all those people, and it was an immediate reaction of our family, but then we thought, you know, hey, we know a lot of people down there, and luckily, the next day, they all called, and everybody seemed to be okay.
I think football's a good escape, you know. My whole life, that's a death in the family, you know, breaking up with a girlfriend, failing a test, whatever. Football's always been an escape, you know, for me personally.
I think my life has changed because of this, because now I just take everything and put it into a big circle now. I mean, I just put myself and my family into a perspective and just realize that, I mean, your time can come at any given moment, and you just have to play to the fullest and live life for the moment.
Are you going to have any special message for them for this game?
No, none whatsoever. It's the same thing we do every time we go out. I talked to him. I said, you're not guaranteed a game next week or next time. And I always ask him, I said, if you knew and someone told you this was the last football game you'd ever play, how would you like to be remembered? However you want to be remembered, play like it, because you never know, it might be your last game.
Every everywhere you go, you see the American flag, and that's sort of a reminder of what happened. You never want to forget something like that.
Red Cross disaster donations from New York City and Washington, D.C.
Shortly before kickoff, the Owls all recognized the poignancy of the special moment.
We're all united as American people. It's really great to watch how people have united in this, you know, time of tragedy.
You look around, even at the other team, and say, hey, we're all American, and we're all in this together. And this is just a sport that we come to play, and it builds a deeper love for everything you do in life, especially everything you do in America.
I don't know if somebody watching Rice in Nebraska play football games really going to get their mind off of this. I don't know. If it does get one person's mind off of this, that'd be great, and it'd be worth playing.
And next week, the Owls take a much longer flight. They play at Hawaii. They're going to make a week out of it. They're going to leave on Tuesday.